Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. Now for today's video, I wanted to talk about a fan favorite dinosaur, the Dilophosaurus, specifically how this animal was designed early on during the development of the first Jurassic Park. So Dilophosaurus, or the spitter as it's more commonly called, is the species of dinosaur that obviously kills Dennis Nedry in the original film. The way in which this animal takes the man down is attributed to its unique ability to project a venomous spray into the eyes of its prey. It does this before attacking its victims while they're blinded. Now, this trait comes specifically from Michael Crichton's original Jurassic Park book, and wasn't really anything that existed within the real life creature that we know of today in the fossil record. With that being said, it's made clear that in the novel, the Dilophosaurus that kills Nedry is actually a fully grown individual, while the one that we see in the 1993 movie was nowhere near that size. And this wouldn't be the only change that was made while translating the novel to film. You see, when they were making the first movie, the production art department added in a reptilian feature. When the dinosaur prepared to spit, a fan-like hood, which was normally folded back against its neck, would flare out just like what you'd see with something like the Australian frilled lizard. Early concept art for this design and feature of the Dilophosaurus shows us some of the fun skin tones that Stan Winston's crew were working with at the time, one of which features a very Halloween-inspired black and orange color scheme, which I think looks pretty cool. By the way, one of the things I like the most about this concept art happens to be the fact that you can actually see the venom glands, which are situated around the spitter's throat, really, really clearly here. Now, they do show up in the final film as well, but their size has kind of been reduced, and I'm sure that most people probably weren't even aware that they were even there, or the fact that you can see them actually expand before the dinosaur spits at Dennis. Interestingly, the actual reason the Dilophosaurus isn't fully grown in Jurassic Park was actually also a production decision as well, which has always been attributed to the filmmakers trying to avoid any audience members as having confusion between the Dilophosaurus and the Velociraptors, which if they made the Dilos fully grown would have been comparable in size, so they decided to make the spitters only 4 feet tall during Nedry's death scene. By the way, the Topps comic book adaptation for the 1993 movie features a radically different design that I don't really see too many people ever talking about, but this version of the creature actually doesn't have crests, and instead comes complete with alien-like antenna, which makes for a seriously freaky and almost Avatar-esque monster in comparison. Now, when it came time to finally design the real dinosaur, they ultimately went with the green and bluish striped creature that we all saw in the first movie. But from all of the wild decisions that were made on set that ultimately went into designing the iconic animal, it's just really cool for myself and I'm sure many other fans to go over some of these older concepts just for comparison's sake, nerfing the animal's size so that they wouldn't be confused for the raptors, giving the animal that lizard-like frill, going through color scheme decisions, and finally, putting the final skin over top of Rick Gallantson's mechanical skeleton. These are all really cool parts of the Dilophosaurus evolution that I've always been interested in, and just changing one of these specific decisions drastically alters that scene and gives it an entirely different feel or context, but only what was finished with the shoot on the first movie truly became iconic. With that being said, I'm extremely hopeful that we'll see this animal return in Jurassic World Dominion, and since Colin Trevorrow has been teasing it, I definitely hope that maybe this time we'll even get to see one that's fully grown, but I guess we're all just gonna have to wait another year and a half until we get to see anything of the movie. So anyways guys, what are your own thoughts and opinions on this dinosaur? Which of these earlier concepts do you think looks the coolest, and what's your favorite design of the spitter in general? By the way, that whole weird alien antenna thing from the comic books, what do you think about that? Now, whatever your own thoughts and opinions on all of this stuff happens to be, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Now before I go, I'd like to thank all of my game wardens, as well as all of my in-gen executives. I'd also like to thank all of my park workers and in-gen hunters as well. Guys, it seriously means the world to me that all of you continue to support what I do, and I never want you to ever forget that. Now, I'd like to thank all of you for watching today's video, and hope you all enjoyed the content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like, and hope that you'll all consider subscribing if you're interested in hearing from me again. I'll see you all in the next video, guys, and as always, take it easy.